of things. We don't have a whole lot of announcements today, and we don't have a bulletin either. So check your emails. I sent everything out in the email, okay? Nothing big. As far as, like, giving, I forgot at church to bring up the collection. So there's a big white plastic basket right up here by where the food is. That sucker better be full. No, I'm just kidding. It's there. Put it in there. Bring it next week. I was looking for something to use. I couldn't find anything else. So it's just that little tiny, like, white basket. Feel free to go ahead and use it in that. Or give it, well, whatever. Put it over there by the plastic bag. Linda will pick it up afterwards, okay? So with that, this is kind of what we're going to do. We're going to open up with some prayer. Then we're going to bring up our families that are joining in membership. And then we'll go into one more song before we go into our baptism service, okay? So with that, why don't we bow our heads and pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day that you've given us. Lord, it's been a summer of rain and cold, and today you've given us sunshine and warmth, and we thank you for that, Lord. Thankful for every single person that's here. Lord, you knew from the beginning of time who would be here worshiping together as brothers and sisters in the faith. And we're thankful for that, Lord God. As we worship today in the sanctuary that you've provided, we pray that you forgive us of our sins. Lord, wipe us clean. Let us empty ourselves of anything that's prevent us from growing closer to you. And Lord, we know that your forgiveness is there, your grace is there, and it's there in abundance. And that because of your grace and your forgiveness, we can stand in your presence, not based on anything that we do, but on everything that you've done. Lord, we love you. Lord, we lift up to you everyone that's on our prayer requests. Lord, we lift up to you the Wolf family. We have been praying for them for months, Lord God. And with the passing of Tiffany, I pray that you give them strength. And I pray that you watch over them, Lord God. And that you give them guidance and the wisdom and comfort for the weeks and months ahead. We lift up to you everyone else that is on our prayer requests. We continue to pray for our little brother Gage, who's recovering from his concussion, Lord. We give thanks to you for our sister Sandy, who is feeling better after being sick for weeks. And we're so thankful for that, Father God. And for all the other prayer requests that we have, Lord, even those that have gone unspoken, we lift those up to you because you know everything and there's nothing we can hide from you. So we lift all of that up to you, Lord Jesus. And as we're gathered here, as brothers and sisters in the faith, Lord, we'll pray to you with one voice in the words that our Savior gave us, and everyone pray with you. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
All right. So, I'm just going to share this one thing. So, I started my class for the semester yesterday. And I think you guys know my area of specialization is going to be spiritual formation. And so, you'll probably hear me throw things in weekly that I'm learning. And I read a chapter out of a book last night that talked about the power that the Holy Spirit brings when brothers and sisters in the faith pray together out loud. It's really awesome. You know, and as I just sit here and I thought about it, I had a professor that always used to say that if we could put on spiritual glasses, we could see all sorts of angels around us when we call on the Lord and when we're praying to the Lord. And I just think it's awesome to have that thought in mind as we're gathered here today. So with that, we're going to go into our families that are going to be joining us officially in membership. And I'm going to call them up here in just a second. We're going to be reading a covenant, and then they're also going to be receiving this very prestigious certificate. Now, I will tell you, the secretary will be fired because we haven't done this in a couple years, and the secretary did not realize that the name was updated since. So for the next one, it'll be updated. And in case you're wondering, the secretary is me. So I realized that afterwards. So I hope the Sharpie has dried from when I fixed it, okay? If you want to frame this, I'll get you a new one with the updated name next week, okay? But here's what I want to talk about. The families that are joining today, they're joining on a professional thing. They've all received the Lord. I've talked to them about their relationship with the Lord. They've all been baptized at other points, and they're not getting baptized today. But I want to point out one cool thing about the people that are joining membership. And I think that I don't know if there's a right way or a wrong way, but these are folks that started coming to church and consistently came to church over weeks and months, and they got to know us and they got to know what we're about, and then the Lord moved on them to join our congregation officially. And that's really kind of the way in the past things worked in the early church. Folks would come and they would learn and they would check it out, and then they would feel that calling of the Lord saying, you know, this is where the Lord wants me. And then they make the move to join. And I think that's wonderful. Some of the members that are going to be up here have been attending pretty regularly for the last 6 or 7 months. Some of them have been attending pretty regularly for 3 years. But it's always awesome to be able to receive this into our membership. So we're going to bring them up, and in front of the whole congregation, they're going to read the covenant that we do for new members. And then they will get anointed with oil, and they will get the certificate and a little gift. And this is actually... those getting baptized will receive this too. I was thinking about what to give, right? If you look in the Old Testament, there's a tradition that whenever an important event happened or God did something powerful, they would commemorate it by stacking stones or erecting a little stone structure and saying, this is here for remembrance, right? Moses, Joshua, Samuel, David, they all erected these stones. And I started thinking about that. I'm like, you know, how can we do something? And in fact, if you go to a cemetery and you see someone of the Jewish faith that's buried, a lot of times you'll see stones on top of the headstone. And those are when family come and visit, they leave a stone there as a remembrance, right? So these are little paperweights that look like a diamond that have the ichthus on it, the fish for Jesus. And you can put this somewhere in your house, on your desk, and kind of a remembrance of what you've done today. Either a remembrance that you're joining the family of faith officially, or remembrance that today you're being baptized in obedience to the command of the Lord, right? So that'll be what you'll be receiving today when you come up. So with that, the families that are going to join will have come up, Linda Hankins, the Justs, and the McIntyres. Come on up. So this is the covenant. You guys respond to the questions that I read. And church, be in prayer for these new families that are joining us today. All right, so for all of you, I'll ask, are you striving to love the Lord your God with all your mind, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength? And are you striving to love your neighbor as yourself? And do you desire to serve Christ through Fairhaven Church? On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you truly and earnestly repent of your sins? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you receive the Holy Spirit, the giver and the sustainer of life? Do you profess the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament? Do you promise to the best of your abilities and according to the grace given you to keep God's holy will and commandments and to walk in the same all the days of your life as a faithful member of Christ's holy church? May the Lord defend you with his heavenly grace, and by the Holy Spirit confirm you as a member of the faith and fellowship of the family of Jesus Christ in Fairhaven Church. Amen. another thing that I like to do for new members is to, we're covenanting together here, right? They're joining the church as part of a covenant in the Old Testament. Covenants were often finalized by the pouring on of oil and the anointing of oil. So I'm going to anoint each of you with oil in the name of our Savior Jesus.
For each new male member, we propose this. We made a solo for you guys to come up here and sing for us. So, Dave, you're first.
Brothers and sisters, let's give them a round of applause.